Hello everyone, welcome to the course of Power System Analysis 2. So I'm Sushmita Sarkar from RV College of Engineering, handling your module 1 in this particular course. So in our last two lectures, we have learned about network model formulation and formation of Ybus. So this particular lecture, we will be see the formation of Ybus by inspection method, but in the presence of regulating transformer. So let us go for our today's course. So will be today's topic, that is the formation of Ybus in presence of regulating transformer. So here we see is that regulating transformer is used in transmission lines to control. The very first thing is to the real power. Fine, and how do we control this real power? We control this by varying the phase angle of the voltage, which we assign it as a delta. Fine, and the second thing is the reactive power. So reactive power will be controlled by the magnitude of the voltage. So fine, so usually we another terms we say as that P and delta are tightly coupled and Q and magnitude of V are tightly coupled. So these are the main four parameters which we need to know in load flow analysis. Fine, so please remember this because the concept we'll be using in fast decoupled load flow method. So now the regulating transformer, we put in the transmission line, the main reason is to control these two parameters. That is number one, real power, and second one, reactive power. Okay, so now if we say consider a transmission line, which is showing in the regulating transformer, is representing in a transmission line in this particular format. So we want to know exactly the regulating transformer is connected near to which bus, whether it is connected to the near to the bus one or bus two, because it does matter when you solve the problem. Fine, so now here, so we'll be seeing it that equivalent representation of the line with the help of, in the presence of regulating transformer. So see, this is an equivalent diagram of the previous network, which I have shown you. So that regulating transformer will be represented in this particular format if the regulating transformer is having a ratio of 1:A. So this A is called as off nominal ratio, and this value will vary from 0 to 1. And this, why this is called as off nominal ratio? Because this value is not used for the calculation of base value for this particular line, and hence it is called as off nominal ratio. This value is very less because this is used, the regulation transformers are used in the transmission line just to boost up the line voltages, that is up to plus minus of 10%. Fine, so that is the reason why we keep the regulating transformer in the transmission line. The ratio can be 1:A or it can be 1:A. So we should see that how does the network changes when the ratio of these transformer changes. Fine, so now with this, let us write the equation of this equivalent network. So you can see, guys, this is I dash. So I have taken the bus one, which is having a voltage of V1, and the bus two having a voltage of V2. So if the transformer comes over here, whose transformation ratio is 1:A, so definitely the voltage after the transformer will change, and which we are saying it as a V1 dash. And similarly, the current also will change to I1 dash. So now the series line impedance, admittance, I put it as Y12 over here. So current which is flowing from this direction to this direction after the transformer is I1 dash, and from this bus to this bus has been considered as I2. So now how do I write this equation? My I1 dash equation will be nothing but V1 dash minus the V2 multiplied by Y12. Simple, the difference in the voltage at the two ends multiplied by the admittances. Fine, so now next, what do I know? The ratio or the transformation ratio, what do we say? The V1 by V1 dash is equal to 1 by A is equal to 1 dash, 1 I1 dash by I1. So we know the primary by secondary, we go through a voltage ratio, and secondary by primary, we go as a current ratio. Fine, that's how we define the transformation ratio. So I just rewrite this previous equation as V1 dash is equal to A times of V1. From this equation, put the value of V1 dash as V1 into A. I want to replace this equation in terms of V1 and I1. So V1 dash, I'm getting in terms of V1, that is A into V1. Similarly, The I1 dash from this equation will be I1 by A. So substitute this value of V1 dash and I1 dash in your equation number one. So when you do that, what do we get it as? I1 dash, the equation was, so it becomes I1 by A is equal to V1A minus V2 into Y12. Fine, now I can rearrange this equation and get the A over here. So you get it as I1 is equal to V1A square A into V2 multiplied by Y12. Fine, so now I will open the bracket and rewrite the equation. I will be getting as A square Y12 V1 minus A into Y12 V2. So basically I am getting the equation of I1 in terms of V1 and V2, and I'm assigning this equation as equation number four. Similarly, I'm writing the I2 equation. So I2 equation is going to be V2 minus of V1 dash multiplied by Y12. So V2 V1 dash is nothing but your A into V1. Fine, so V2 minus A into V1 will be Y12. Even if you open the bracket, rearrange it, get the term of V1 first and the V2 next. So what do you get it as? Y2 is equal to minus A Y12 into V1 plus Y12 into V2. So now you can see that the equation number four and equation number five are representation of the respective bus currents in terms of their bus voltages. So I1 equation in terms of V1, V2, and I2 equation in terms of V1 and V2. Fine, now I'm going to write this equation, both four and five, in a matrix form. So you can put it in a matrix form, these two equations. So when you write I1 and I2 and V1 and V2, just substitute the values of these. This was your I1 equation was A square Y12 into V1 minus A into Y12 into V2. So I'm just putting those values in a matrix form. Fine. So now I am putting, by seeing this Y bus, okay, by seeing this Y bus value, I'm going to draw the network. Fine. So all of you know that this off diagonal elements represents the negative of the series impedance, series admittance. So negative of the series admittance means negative of this value will be AY12. So basically it is a pi model of the transmission line. So this is A12. So now these two diagonal elements will be usually consisting of the half-line charging admittances. So we don't know exactly what is the half-line charging admittance value. So we are just going to put it as X and X dash. So let us find out what is this X value and X dash value. So now guys, if I have to know, this is the term is Y11. Okay, this is the term Y11. So I'll just write over here to make you understand this. Fine. So this basically, this term is Y11, okay? This term is Y22, fine? And this is your Y12, and this is your Y21. So now if I have to know the value of X over here, so what will be my equation at this particular point? What will be the equation? Equation is going to be Y11 is equal to X plus of this line plus of this line, A of Y12. Okay, so now from this I want to know the value of X. So X is going to be Y11 minus A of Y12. And from where do I get this A11? I get this, from where I would get this Y11? Y11, I get it from here. So substitute the value of Y11, which will give you A square Y12 minus A of Y12. Fine, I hope I made you clear this. Fine, so you substitute that value, take the common term outside and rewrite the equation. So with this, I will be just going to the next. So you will be seeing, observing the same equation. So from pi model, this was a pi model. So from here, I'm going to write the Y11. So you can see Y11 is equal to AY12 plus of X. So from this, get the value of X. Fine, so you just substitute the value of Y11 from the previous matrix. So you get the Y11 and you write X is equal to A square minus A Y12. Similarly, you write X dash. How do you get the X dash? That is Y22. Y22 is equal to A of Y12 plus of X dash. This plus this will give you Y22. Fine, so that's what I'm writing. So from here, you can find out the x dash from your previous matrix. You can see the value of y22 was y12. Okay, so that the value of y22, you substitute over here, it is y12, which is equal to ay12 plus x dash. So from this, the x dash value will be rearranged this. So this will become minus. So you get it as y12 minus of ay12. So 1 minus a common, you get it as y12. So basically, I am getting this equation and this equation for an equivalent pi model when the ratio is 1:A, when your regulating transformer ratio is 1:A. Now, what will be the equation if my transformer ratio changes to a:1? If my transformation ratio changes from 1:A to a:1, definitely your formula will also change. So guys, this is an assignment for you. Please derive this for a transformation ratio of a:1. So let us see the final answer. So it will help you to do the problem. So that's what I'll show you, the direct pi model for a:1. And I request all of you to derive this to get that particular model. Fine. So this is the a:1 transformation ratio pi model. So you can see. So in this case, this will be y23 by a. This is y23 a by 1 minus by a, and y23 by a minus 1. So dear students, you will be getting this value easily, the same formulas you have to use, but just keeping the ratio of not 1:A, it is going to be a:1. So obviously your transformation ratio formula will change. Fine. So now what happens, whether it is a:1 or it is 1:A? What happens is, we can see that if you substitute in these equations, a:1, if you substitute a:1 over here, or you substitute a:1 over here, what will be the answer? This will be your x, because this is basically your x, okay? And this is basically your x dash. So you can see your x and x dash will automatically become zero. So that means, as good as you are representing a transmission line without a regulating transformer. Fine. So hope I am clear with the concept of regulating transformer. How does it affect? But only thing you have to remember, you have to remember in both the case of ratios, the formulas, because when you put it in an inspection method, the particular line which is having a regulated transformer should be converted into a pi model. And then you just use your Y-bus by inspection method technique. Fine. So to understand that, let us take one problem. So the problem is, the line data of a power system is shown below. Obtain Y-bus of the system using the method of inspection with regulating transformer at bus P. Fine. So what does it mean by regulating transformer at bus P? So you can see your bus code 1-2. If this particular line has a regulating transformer, it will be represented by a value. If the value is 1, so you can see this is your regulating transformer column. Fine. So here the value is 1. If the value is 1, that means this particular line has no regulating transformer. Fine. And if the value is 0.8, fine. If the value is 0.8, anything less than 1, between 0 and 1, that means this particular line has a regulating transformer which is having a ratio of, this ratio is by default, we take it as a:1. So basically, this particular column represents a:1 ratio of regulating transformer. So fine, in this you will see the regulating transformer is placed near to bus 2, because the question says the inspection method with the regulating transformer at bus P. So this is a bus code is P2Q. So this, the first bus will be denoted as P, and the second bus, this particular bus is P. Okay, and this particular is Q. So if it is near to P, means the regulating transformer is near to the Pth bus. That means when you draw the network, your regulating transformer should be represented at bus P. Fine. So now, similarly, 3-4 is also having a regulating transformer, since the value is 0.9 and it is near to the bus 3. And the last line doesn't have any transformer, regulating transformer, since the ratio is 1. Fine. Now, one more thing to notice over here, that we have a line charging admittance. Fine, 0.4 and 0.4 in the last two lines where we don't have regulating transformer, it is not necessary that if you have the transformers in any two line, you will not have half line charging admitters. It is nothing like that. Any line can have half line charging admitters, but this particular problem, we just try to cover both the methods, whether half line charging is also present and regulating transformer is also present, how to solve it. Okay, so let us go and see how to draw the network of this. Remember, the data says 1 to 2, 2 to, so 1 bus 1 to bus 2 connection, 2 to 3 connection, 3 to 4 connection, and 4 back to 1 connection. So how does the network looks? And line number 2 and 3 has the regulating transformer. Fine. So you remember your half line charging, your line charging admittances were given as J.04. So I told you if the line charging is written, it should be divided by 2. So you can see here it is J.02 and J.02. So basically your transformer is lying between second line and the third line. So the second line, the transformer is near the bus 2, and in the third line, the transformer is near the bus 3. Fine. So in this way, how to go about it? These two lines does not have half line charging admittances. Even if you have, just draw it and later on add it. Fine. So right now the other two lines have it. So let us see how to go for such kind of networks, how to solve it if the regulating transformers are present in the system. So what we'll do it, we'll take one line at a time. So let us say line 2 to 3, because I have to convert the line into a pi model. So directly if I show you the pi model, then it may not be very clear to you people. Fine. So I will be showing you the pi model of the first this particular line. I will be showing you first for this particular line, then I will solve for this, and then we'll put it back in this particular network. Fine. So let us see. I have taken the bus 2 and 3, the line between bus 2 and 3, so which is having a transformation ratio of 0.8. I have told you guys this ratio by default will be taken as A:1. So you guys have to remember the formula for A:1 pi model. Fine. So the basically it is 0.8 and minus J4, the series admittance as given in the problem. And this is between line to bus 2 and 3. Fine. So when we draw the pi model for this, so this is the formula for the pi model. Fine. Y23 is nothing but minus of J4. Y23 is nothing but minus of J4. And A is given as 0.8. Both the values, just substitute the values. Y23 is minus J4. And A value is 0.8. So substitute over here and get the values. It's fine. So like this, when you substitute for both the lines, when I substitute Y23 or Y34 value and A value, I respective A value and respective series admittance value. This is the pi model which I get for the bus number 2, line number 2. And this is the pi model which I get for line number 3. Okay. So just please, all of you, cross check the values, whether you are getting the same answer or not. Fine. So now after this, all of you know how to solve it. Correct. If I have to find out what is Y11 of the, if you have to know what is Y11 of the Y bus matrix, so you know, you have to add this value plus this value plus this value and plus this value. The four lines which are connected to the bus 1 will give you the Y11. Fine. Similarly, Y22 will be this value, this, and this. This will give you Y22. Fine. So, and you know that the off diagonal elements Y12 will be minus of minus J4. So, which will give you J4. Okay. That particular thing will give you J4. So, this is how we solve for the regulating transformer. So this is how I have substituted the values of Y11. I told you all the four lines which are connected to the bus number 1 will give you Y11. Similarly, Y22, Y33, and Y44. Fine. And off diagonal elements, wherever it is connected, it will show you value, and wherever it is not connected, it will show you the zero value. So that's how you get your Y bus with the help of regulating transformer. I hope the logic of regulating transformer is clear to all of you. Fine. So now it's a quiz time, guys. So let us see what do we have for a quiz. Fine. Number 1, transformation ratio A can be varied from. Please answer the A value, which we call it as a transformation ratio value or off nominal value, the value of this A can be varied from. Okay, good. Those who have given answer 0 to 1. Okay, so the answer is 0 to 1. Similarly, next question. Why A is known as off nominal turns ratio? Please, anybody can answer that question. Why A is known as off nominal ratio? Why we have given such kind of name when we have already called them as a transformation ratio? Why then we again separately give a name as off nominal turns ratio? I have just explained to you in the beginning. Fine, right? Few of you have got the right answer. I hope so. So the reason is because this voltage ratio is not used for determining the ratio of base KV of the lines. Okay. It is nowhere you don't consider this particular value for calculating the base KVs. Okay. So that's the reason why it is known to be an off nominal turns ratio. Fine. And the last question, question number 3. The value of A is very small. Why? What is the reason that the transformation ratio is very small? Yeah, the answer is because the regulating transformer is used to boost up the line voltages up to a very small value, which we take as plus or minus 10% of the transmission line voltage. Okay, so with this, I hope the concept of regulating transformer presence of regulating transformer in the transmission line is clear to all of you, and how does this regulating transformer affects the Y-bus components. Okay, with this I stop today's lecture, and I hope all of you have understood my last three lectures. Next lecture I'll be bringing the concept of formation of Y-bus with singular transformation, which is very interesting, because before going to the singular transformation, we should understand the concept of incidence matrix. So a little bit of network topology is required to understand the singular transformation method. Fine. So before going to that, I thought it is very important for you to know that how to solve Y-bus by inspection method with and without regulating transformer. So I hope all of you have understood so far. Thank you. Have a nice day.